When a star explodes in the depth of a galaxy, it creates a huge light show for humans to see from Earth. But most of the time they are hidden. There could be 100,000 million stars in a galaxy, maybe even more. But in every 100 years, only a few supernovas are observed.
A supernova is so big that we cannot probably miss watching them with the naked eye. Supernovas are the most powerful explosion in the entire universe. When they occur, they should brighten up the night sky. But we do not really see any. Why so? Let's learn some physics. To find the answer, we will have to come back to our own planet. In a desert, there is only one thing that is everywhere. Can you guess what? Yes, dust. The answer to not being able to watch supernovas are buried inside the dust. But space dust is not exactly the same. A new study led by an associate scientist working on the JWST mid-infrared instrument, Dr. Ori D. Fox, answers the question. The study showed NASA's Spitzers detected 5 supernova explosions that happened in the vastness of the cosmos silently, without showing the beautiful light show to us. The supernova went with a bang, but the dust cloud blocked the visible light coming from it. Spitzer was only able to watch it because of its infrared detection capabilities. The infrared light, the same light that your TV remote uses, has a very long wavelength. It can pass through dense regions of dust and gas. The same thing happens on Earth also. The most amount of light that we get is absorbed by the clouds and dust particles in the Earth's atmosphere. Some are reflected back to space. But we get infrared light as it can pass through most of the layers of the atmosphere. Earth also emits infrared light during nighttime. That reduces the Earth's surface temperature by a small fraction. To find supernovas in space, scientists used their big eye, the Spitzer telescope. They started to observe 40 different dusty galaxies. Then they found that supernovas are not so rare. They occur as frequently as scientists have predicted. Hiding behind the dust clouds, the star's life cycle ends with a bang. Cosmic dust or space dust is not exactly the same as dust on the Earth. The biggest difference is its fineness. Cosmic dust is so fine that it can be measured with few molecules. They usually measure between 0.1 millimeters, 100 micrometers. Though there are a few kinds of cosmic dust, the dust that was blocking the visible light coming from galaxy ARP-148 is much finer. According to Dr. Ori D. Fox, we were unable to watch most supernovas because of our way of finding them. The optical survey we use to search for supernovas is why we may have missed half of the supernova explosions that occurred in space. The number of the predicted supernovas was much more than actually observed in space. He also said, if we had used this method to find the supernovas, then we could have watched twice than we watched till today. This is called the supernova discrepancy. In the universe, there are many galaxies that are very young. Young galaxies have more dust and gas clouds. On those young galaxies, more stars are forming every once in a while. As a result of this dust's absorption and scattering of optical and ultraviolet light, telescopes cannot see it. Researchers have long believed that the supernovas that are missing must occur, but are just not visible. Some undergraduate students have also played a vital role in this study. It was not a sure success observation. This was done based on some hunch. So it was very hard for the young minds. But they did promising work and helped to find the missing supernovas. The kind of supernova that has here been observed by Spitzer is from stars 8 times massive than our Sun. The core of these giant stars starts to fill with iron. As lower atomic numbered atoms get bigger because of the fusion process that keeps the stars burning. As the core fills with iron, the life of the stars starts to shrink. When the core is fully filled with heavy atoms like iron, the star's life comes to an end. The gravity becomes so much that the outer layers of the star cannot keep producing enough energy to keep on going. Suddenly, it collapses inside its own core. This is how most heavy elements in this universe came into place. These explosions scatter the heavy elements everywhere in space. This is how the rocket planets like Earth, Mars has come into existence. This is from where you, me, everyone else actually came into existence. A few years back, scientists discovered that Betelgeuse has lost its brightness. So everyone was so excited. Astronomers thought this will be the first supernova that will be visible from the Earth's night sky without a telescope. It is only 724 light years away, and you can easily find it in the night sky. It is the right shoulder star of the constellation Orion. As if Betelgeuse explodes, its brightness will be similar to some planets, or maybe brighter. But Betelgeuse did not explode. The dimming was most significant in the last 50 years. Its brightness fainted by 2.5 times. This was a sure indication that Betelgeuse has come to the end of its life cycle. Then what happened next? Why did it not explode? The star had ejected a huge amount of gas, and the gas had condensed into dust. The dust came in between our line of sight and Betelgeuse. That is what caused the dimming. So the dust is hiding a lot of beautiful things from our sight. When the dust passed, the line of sight of Betelgeuse again became bright as it used to be. A recent study just published on the 5th of August says something interesting about the dimming of the star. This study shows evidence of a large spot on the surface of Betelgeuse. The study led by Dr. Sofia Alexeyeva argues that dimming was indeed occurred by dropping its effective temperature by at least 170 K on 2020 January 31st, which can be connected to the emergence of a large dark spot on the surface of the star. This study includes spectroscopic evidence for their claim. Whether it happens because of dust or a dark spot, Betelgeuse is indeed at the end of its life cycle and it will explode any time now. Or maybe it has already exploded. If it explodes today, we will only be able to know about that 724 years later. It will end with a bang as a Type 2P supernova.